the 73 Undersigned Civil Society Organization appalled by the news of another death at the MSCC, Nation Anti-Corruption Commission office, that reportedly occurred yesterday around 10:15 a.m. The victim, believed to be Ahmad Sarbani Mohamad, 56 years old, an assistant director of the Selangor Custom Department, had been released on bail 3 days ago, but was found dead on the first floor of MACC building at Jalan Kok Reng. To best of our knowledge, this is the second time a fellow citizen has died while under the custody of MACC. The fact that this comes not long after the death of Teo Beng Hock in July 2009 is a real cause for concern for the peoples of this nation. This incident has again raised questions on the integrity and accountability of the MACC. Public confidence in the credibility and professionalism of the MACC has been shattered. We are extremely saddened that the very institution of the state that are supposed to protect and advance the public interest have apparently abandoned the principle of democratic governance. Not only have human freedom and dignity have been degraded, life have been unnecessarily lost. Principally, we do not condemn any corruption activities. We support the anti-corruption agency's effort in fighting graft, but right to life is above all. Fighting graft must not be at the expense of a life. We demand the government, as a matter of utmost urgency, undertake the following measures. The establishment of a Royal Commission of Inquiry immediately to independently and thoroughly investigate the say incident. The terms of reference of the proposed Royal Commission inquiry must include investigation into the key role of the present command and power structure of MACC in this tragic incident. Half the members of the RCI must be nominated by civil society organization to ensure credibility. Secondly, the police must back up and carry out independent and professional investigation against MACC. They must clear their reputation and regain credibility in this incident. The police have failed to neither investigate nor take action on 59 complaints of abuse of power against MACC. Its inaction caused 2 deaths, Teo Beng Hock and now Ahmad Sarbani Mohamad. Thirdly, the MACC investigation director, Dr. Mustafa Ali, and all officers involved in the investigation of the case must be immediately suspended until the completion of the Royal Commission's work to ensure justice is served and there is no cover-up of evidence or any obstruction to the investigation process. And finally, immediately implement the recommendation by the Parliamentary Select Committee on the Penal Code, on the Penal Code and Criminal Procedure Code, to enact the Coroner's Act in Malaysia and to establish a Coroner's Act to investigate all cases of sudden deaths in custody.